It's a world of laughter, a world of tears, whoa, whoa, it's a world of hope and a world of fear. Whoa, whoa, there's so much that we share that it's time we're aware. Oh, it's a small world, small, after all. Whoa, 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 yeah.
And in this small world, they are our community's most vulnerable, our children.
It was a six-year-old child who 3 days beforehand had broken out with chicken pox. And of course his parents, you know, thought it's just chicken pox. But unfortunately, he's one of the children who had complications. And 3 days after he broke out in his chicken pox, he actually went into a coma. And he never woke up. And we turned off the ventilator and put him in his mother's arms. And that was the day I swore to myself that whatever I could do to make sure no other child died from chicken pox, I would do what it took.
My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish.
As a community, we can do much more than just wish. We can take action. The El Rio Community Health Center has taken the lead by committing to immunize any child who comes through our doors. El Rio serves around 35,000 children every year. Before El Rio launched its dedicated immunization program, only about 35% of those children were properly immunized. Today, 97% are vaccinated. That means that almost every child who walks through our doors will walk out protected. But for the staff at El Rio and members of the El Rio Foundation, that simply was not good enough. The goal became to get all school-age children in our community, not just El Rio patients, but all children, vaccinated.
To get people to be coming to the clinics, to mobilize them, it's difficult. So we thought, well, why not take the clinics to them? And what better venue than a neighborhood shopping center? So we went to our friends over the Basha family and asked them to help support us.
The plan? Launch a citywide back-to-school vaccination program. But to pull this off, the El Rio Foundation would need an army of staff and volunteers and community support, and more than just a little luck.
Let me get you a book real quick, okay?
Sign for the hepatitis A.
It means they can start school, because otherwise they wouldn't be able to start school right now.
It's not only free, but it's right when school starts, you know what I mean? When you don't have the shots that you need to start school, and then it's right on time, you know what I mean?
We take out somewhere between 40 and 50 staff members, and we spend several hours working with the Food City staff, creating a clinic within a grocery store.
Mother. So I need the mother in the front and the children behind, because I need to put another family there.
The goal became, if your children need their shots, they'll get them, like it or not.
Oh man, it's like dream come true for us, you know. Right now, you know, the situation, you know, it's tough for everybody, you know.
The need was great. The lines were long, but by the time the last shot was administered in the community this summer, almost 4,000 vaccines were given to more than 1,500 children. These parents know that just one shot can make a life-altering difference in the life of a child. 20 years ago, Pat Anderson, then a single mom, knew she had to immunize her baby son. And she did. She took little Christopher in for every required shot available. But back then, shots for meningitis were not required until 15 months of age. Chris was just 10 months when he became deathly ill.
I woke up on a Saturday morning about 4 and he was crying, and I tried to give him a bottle and he didn't want it. And I realized he was very warm. I took his temperature under the arm and it was 106 degrees. And they ran a battery of tests on this poor little boy and finally did a spinal tap, and he had meningitis. He was in a self-contained special ed class all the way through high school. He was integrated for things like chorus and PE and art and some other things, but all of his basic core classes have always been through a self-contained special ed program.
One shot, a few seconds, could have prevented Christopher from falling ill. He's now 20, but functions at around a fifth grade level.
You know, I should have a 20-year-old who's off in college right now, dating, talking about a career, and now I don't. I have a young man who thankfully has graduated from high school, works, has a job, works independently, but it's different. He will always be dependent upon his family for something for the rest of his life.
No question his family loves him and supports him, but even so, says Pat, she is haunted by the thought of what if. What if Christopher would have had that one shot 18 years ago? What would his life be like today?
I have a 20-year-old son who is disabled, and disabled for life.
The El Rio staff believes no parent should have to go through what Christopher's family has endured. Last year in our community, El Rio administered some 36,000 vaccines to more than 12,000 children. We don't know how many little lives have been saved, but we do know this: there is never a time to let up. Immunizations are just too important.
Chris is who Chris is, and I love him for who he is, and I can't change that. What frustrates me more than anything is people out there who won't immunize their children and don't understand what could happen, how much their lives could change.
But I can't think of anything more fundamental to be involved with and to write a check to or to be partners with than El Rio, because it keeps people healthy. And a community without health is not a community. We need to keep people healthy. We need to keep funding El Rio. And that's the goal I have, and I hope everybody involved in watching this will be part of it. We can do it. Just be able.